Hi everyone, I'm Jeff from Two Lives Left, and in this video I'll be giving you a sneak peek of the upcoming AirCode 2.0 feature of Codea. Now, one major change we're making to AirCode is we're moving away from the web browser and instead implementing it into VSCode. VSCode is a very popular code editor available for free on different platforms. And also, with its extensions, it opens the door to a lot of cool features we'll be showcasing today. Now, just a quick disclaimer, we still have a lot of work to do on this, so there might be issues in the presentation. Now, let's jump right in. I have here Codea running in the simulator, and on the left side, I have Visual Studio Code. Now, in Visual Studio Code, I already have the Codea extension loaded, and in the command palette, you can see all the Codea commands that I have available, one of which is connect to host. So I'm going to connect to Codea using localhost here. And this is going to ask Codea the list of files for the currently loaded project. While it's doing so, let me show you what the project does. Now, I can click Add Parameters, and I have all the different types of parameters that Codea supports at the moment. I can tweak these parameters. So as you can see, it's a very simple project, and it prints hello on setup. And restart it, and you can see that the project is loaded in VS Code now. I can go look at my source files, main.lua here, or my dependencies. I have one dependency, library one, which has a say hello method. This is actually what prints hello in my project. The other files are internal to Codea. You can see the list of files here with their order, the tab order in your project. We made them read-only in AirCode, and you'll have the same thing for the library. Now, obviously, I can start typing some code here. Let's just write world. And I hit save. As soon as you hit save, your update is sent to Codea. Now, I've updated the setup method, so we're not seeing anything. I will have to restart the project. But if I were to change something in my draw method, you would see it right away. Actually, let's do this just now. I'm going to change my BG color, red, to 255. I save, and the background is now red. Let's go back to its original value. There you go. The other things we can do, let's open the command palette, type Codea. We've seen connect to host. I can execute current line. So if my cursor is on the print world line, I can run that, and we see the output here. The other thing we can do from VS Code, I can go to output, Codea, if it's not selected already, and then I see all my outputs here. If I made a typo, save, restart my project, I'm also going to see my errors right inside VS Code. Now let's fix that. We can add new files. Let's add a test Lua. I'm going to use a little code snippet here for a touch method, which currently doesn't do anything. Let's add it to the new file. And now I can break the project because I forgot to restart after introducing the error. All right, now it works. And then we're moving circle around the parameters. We see the Y value getting updated. I can delete this file. Now, when you delete the file, it's not deleting that code yet. The function is still defined, which we can see here. We could either restart the project or we could set touch to nil. I'm going to show, we've seen execute current line, but I can also execute command. So I could execute this command directly from here. And now if I touch, it doesn't do anything anymore in the project. Another thing we can do is execute selection. So if I select this touch method, execute selection, now the touch method is back, even though the file is not there anymore. And finally, another thing we can do is add dependency. And this is going to list all the projects that are available as dependencies. These are projects which have other files than the main.lua file. Here I have library 2. You'll see that the project restarted. This is something we might improve in the future. For now, it was easier to implement it like this. And if we look at the dependencies, we now have a library 2, which has a say by method. So I can add this here to my setup function, restart the project, and we have hello and by. So we've added a dependency. Removing a dependency is as simple as deleting the folder and the dependency is gone. If I restart my project, I'll get an error because say-by is not defined. So that covers the code editor part. Now you might have noticed this Codea icon here on the sidebar of VS Code. If I click here and restart my project, I'm gonna see the same sidebar as inside Codea, and I can click the buttons, move the sliders around, toggles, it works both ways. What's really cool with this is you can close a sidebar in Codea and keep tweaking your project while being in full screen. So that's something we didn't have before. And there's one final feature we have to show, and we believe this is going to be a game changer for debugging your projects, and it is a Lua debugger. Now, let's reload this project. And we can attach from the run and debug window. There you go, I'm attached. And what I can do now is I can set a breakpoint in my draw function. And when you have your breakpoint hit, you'll be able to look at local variables, global variables as well. If I step into this test method, we can see that the local variable A is getting modified as I step line by line. In the globals, there are a lot of global functions. All the functions you can call in Codea are there. So it might be easier to just add a watch of this G value. And then you'll see G equals 2, G equals 3. So this can be extremely useful for debugging your projects. The other thing you can do is hit pause. You won't always have access to the source code. As you can see here, we're kind of in an internal method. When we hit pause, if I step a few times, I'm going to be at the beginning of my draw method. And yeah, that's pretty much it. I hope you like this sneak peek. If you have any comments or suggestion about AirCode 2.0, please go in the forums or on our Discord. I'll put the links in the description. Thanks for watching, and I hope you'll enjoy AirCode 2.0 as much as we do. Bye-bye.